Hi guys, it's Riley, and I have exciting video for you guys today. Exciting. So I have an extreme obsession with Walt Disney World and the Disney parks. I've been there countless times, and I did think I'd be able to go for a long time, but I'm going in May, and I cannot be more excited, more happier, and as I go in a month and a half, I have decided to count down my top 5 attractions from each of the parks. How exciting is that? Oh, I feel like a fool. I'm so excited. These are Riley's must-dos of Walt Disney World. Her must-do, so if I say you must do them, you must do them. So, from the Magic Kingdom, number 5. My number 5 is the Haunted Mansion. And I used to be terrified of this ride for years. And I had gone to Disney World so many times. But the Haunted Mansion is one I would go on, hate it, close my eyes, cover my ears, just want it to be over with, but still go on every time. The thing about the Haunted Mansion, it's not even scary. It's really, really fun. And number 4 is one you don't see a lot of on these lists, and it's Monsters, Inc. Laugh Floor. And I think it's such a cool concept where it has audience participation and you can text some jokes and they might say them, and it's so cool. My cousins are in Disney World right now, and my aunt and my 3-year-old cousin were recently featured on Monsters, Inc. Laugh Floor like today. And they kept saying, oh, where are you from? And they said Michigan. And they tried to rhyme Michigan with Finn, because that's his name. I heard it was so cute and I wish I was there to see it. So that's why it's at number 4, just because of the participation. You can fit so many people and it's honestly, it's really, really funny. So go check that out. Number 3, every time I go to Magic Kingdom, I always get 2 things. A turkey leg and Dole Whip. I know, like, people have said, oh, you can get turkey legs anywhere, like, you don't have to get them at the Magic Kingdom, but if you get them at the Magic Kingdom, it feels more special. They're so good. And then the Dole Whip! Oh my gosh! I think it's in Frontierland. Oh no, the Dole Whip is in Adventureland, and it's so good. Number 2 is the Pirates of the Caribbean, and the Pirates of the Caribbean ride is what started it all. Like all the songs, you're on a little boat on the river. I don't know why I love it so much, but I think it's because it's based off the movie, and that's why I recommend it, because it's so good. And it follows the tale of Captain Jack Sparrow and his pirate adventures. Number 1. Now I kind of cheated a little bit. Number 1 are the mountains, the triple whammy. Space Mountain, Thunder Mountain, Splash Mountain, in that order. Check out Space Mountain. It's single seats. I remember my first time riding it, I was in the middle so my dad could hold onto my shirt so I didn't fall off in the back. As you can't see, it's herky jerky, hurt your back, still, you need to hit that triple whammy. And I put Thunder Mountain at the number 2, just because it's a classic. My baby cousins went on it for the first time today. No, but Thunder Mountain is just a classic Disney ride. Make sure to get fast passes for these mountains. My favorite mountain is Splash Mountain. I don't know why I love it so much, but Splash Mountain is my favorite ride from all the Disney parks. It does twists and turns and, oh, this, it's beautiful. Check out Splash Mountain, check out those fresh from Magic Kingdom. Now we're going to Epcot. Riley's must-dos in Epcot. Number 5, The Seas with Nemo and Friends. Man, so The Seas with Nemo and Friends takes you on a clamshell journey. You can actually see some fish. Marlin's journey to find Nemo, along with The Seas with Nemo and Friends, goes along with actual aquarium part, which I'm also cheating and putting in the aquarium because you have to see the aquarium afterwards. It takes you right out there and it's so cool. I think it's one of the largest saltwater aquariums in the world, and it's, oh my goodness, it's so cool. Number 4, Journey into Imagination. Imagination, one of the first rides I ever remember going on. And it's just a slow moving ride. It takes you through the show into imagination with the 5 senses. By the way, they skip the touch and the taste, but they go through hearing, seeing, and smelling, and it is just so cool. And then after, just check it out. Number 3, Spaceship Earth. Spaceship Earth is basically what's inside the iconic Epcot ball, and it just takes you through the journey of time. And I'm a history nerd. I love history so much, and it's interactive too. It's a touchscreen. You can type in where you're from, blah blah blah. Once you exit this journey of history, which is honestly super 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 cool, and you answer all these questions, it gives you your own personalized future. At the end, you can see where everybody's from around the world, and it takes you to this place where you can like see inventions, and it's super cool. I highly, highly recommend checking out Spaceship Earth. Number two, Soarin'. Ah, Soarin'. You need a fast pass for this one. Everybody wants to ride this one. You're on a hang glider and you just fly through everywhere. And at one point you go into like California and you can smell the oranges. Or is that Florida? Man, I don't really know the ride. But anyway, I highly recommend it. I cry a lot, a lot. Number one, again, I cheated. The World Showcase is number one thing to do at Epcot. Three things to check out at the World Showcase. The Mexico Pavilion. Their food is so good, and inside the temple, there's its own river ride. I recommend checking out the temple and the food. They have churros, they have a lot of things. Just go check the Mexico Pavilion. The Italy Pavilion, just because I like the food a lot. Like, I have to go to the Italy Pavilion every time I go, just to get a small thing of pasta here and there, because it's so good and I love pasta. My number one is the China Pavilion because of the food. We go to this restaurant, it's called The Nine Dragons. It's so good. It's just a walk around China. And then Illuminations, Reflections of Earth. Be sure to stay after for the fireworks for this one. None of the other parks matter, just Epcot's Illuminations, Reflections of Earth. It is the most amazing fireworks show I've ever seen, and I adore it. Like, I cry at Soarin' and I cry at this one. Like, it's just so good. Hollywood Studios. Number five. Muppet Vision 3D. I like this because it parodies different shows and different movies. There's actually a sign that says, I'll be back in 5 minutes, the key's under the mat. You look under the mat and there's actually a key there, so it's super cool. It's pretty funny. I enjoy it a lot. One of the things I recommend doing in Hollywood Studios, just because of its uniqueness, and it's actually pretty funny. They put stuff in your face, there comes in bubbles from the ceiling. So cool. Number four, Toy Story Mania. I heard there's a new Toy Story Land coming out and I won't be there in time. But Toy Story Mania is another 3D shoot things. I always win. I always win at Toy Story Mania. And it's kind of like Buzz Lightyear, Spin, whatever, and Magic Kingdom, which did not make my list. I like Toy Story Mania because it's more accurate and more up to date than Buzz Lightyear, Space Ranger, Spin. Number three, Star Tours. The last time I went on Star Tours, I was the Rebel Spy. Just saying. Another 3D one. I don't know why I keep suggesting 3D ones. You can actually feel yourself jerking around. Every adventure is different. Like, you'll never get the same adventure two times in a row. There's so many different adventures you can go on in Star Tours.
Intermission!
So I put this intermission here for the rest in peace Hollywood Studios rides, because these deserve a mention as well. The Great Movie Ride, I don't know if that one left. I went on the Great Movie Ride one time when I was young and I hated it. But now that I'm older, I want to go out and enjoy it more, but I don't think it's there anymore, so it's kind of sad. And the Backlot Tour. I love the Backlot Tour so, so much. I love the Catastrophe Canyon, I love the Pearl Harbor scene, I loved everything. And then Lights, Motors, Action. And that one was super cool. I don't know if it's still there. Is that one is amazing. It's behind the scenes and I highly, highly recommend it if it's still there. I'm back from the break. Twilight Zone Tower of Terror. If you don't know what this one is, it's just you go into an elevator and up and down, up and down. But I love it so much just because of the atmosphere and the scenery, going into the old hotel, and just you can, like, it smells old and it's just so cool. I love the atmosphere. The atmosphere makes everything. And which is why we come to number one, Rock and Roller Coaster starring Aerosmith. Now, I am a huge roller coaster junkie. That's my thing. So I remember my very first time going on this ride, and I loved it immediately from the bat. I remember I was so excited to finally be tall enough to go on this ride, and I was shaking. I was like, oh my gosh, I'm so scared, but I'm so excited. And it was so, so cool. The queue takes you through the recording studio of one of Aerosmith's recordings, and they're like, hey, we're all invited to the show. There's too many people. Then call a super stretch limo. It goes 0 to 60 in 6.8 seconds, 4.8 seconds, 2.8 seconds. Super, super fast. Oh, it says two inversions, one loop-de-loop. Super fun. I highly, highly recommend it. And plus, right outside in the middle of Rock and Roller Coaster and Tower of Terror, there's a little stand on your left where I get food all the time, and I met a very, very nice lady there last time, and she saw me taking a picture, and she's like, hey, I wanna be in your picture, and I'm like, hey! So I highly, highly recommend going to eat there, because I have to include food in everyone, because I love food. Animal Kingdom. Wow! We're in the last part of the list, and it looks like I'm only 19 and a half minutes in. I'm gonna love editing this. So, number five, Cali River Rapids. People really don't include this one in it, and I don't really know why, because Cali River Rapids is probably one of the most thrilling rides I've been on. Well, the slogan is, you will get wet, you may get soaked. And I think that's so cool, like, you know what you're in for, but you don't know, like, what's gonna happen when you come out. Number four, Festival of the Lion King. I went to the Festival of the Lion King when I was last time I went to Disney World, 4 years ago, and honestly, I wish I would have gone more because it is so cool. There's acrobats, it is amazing. It's so colorful, so bright, so musical. I highly, highly, highly recommend Festival of the Lion King. Like, this is must do, but it's not number one. Number three, Dinosaur! Anybody who knows me knows that I love, love dinosaurs. Dinosaur is one of the ones I highly recommend. I hated it for the longest time because I was a wimp and I was so afraid of it because the dinosaurs are so realistic. I would have nightmares about dinosaurs from this stupid ride. It's one of my favorite rides. It actually is my favorite ride at Animal Kingdom, but it's not number one, and you'll see why. Number two, Expedition Everest. Man, honestly, Expedition Everest would be number one if they got their stupid Yeti to work. Disco Yeti! Takes you on a train ride through the Himalayas. We go backwards, steep drops. It's honestly so cool. I sat next to Nick Jonas on this ride, by the way. Highly recommend. You must get a fast pass for this one. You will not, if you don't want to waste time in line, get a fast pass. Number one, Kilimanjaro Safaris. Kilimanjaro Safari. I love this one so much. You're on a safari and you look at animals. And my favorite animal is called an okapi. I've only seen one a few times in real life, and it was on Kilimanjaro Safari. And it is such a cool experience. You never know what you're gonna see, like elephants, lions, all this other stuff. And it's super, super cool. Highly recommend it. And now the food is the Harambe fruit stand outside of Kilimanjaro Safari. Has fresh fruit, so good, so tasty. Highly, highly recommend the Harambe fruit stand after you go on Kilimanjaro Safari. Well, that was it, folks. That was Riley's must-dos at Walt Disney World. If you enjoyed, be sure to leave a like, comment, all that jazz. I know this was kind of not one of my normal videos, but that's okay. But yeah, I'm super excited for Disney World. I'll be sure to vlog it when I go. And yeah, have a great day.